Hello everyone. Today we are starting with the sixth chapter of history, that is towns, traders and craftsmen. During the medieval period, a large number of new towns developed in different parts of India. There were port towns, trading towns, pilgrimage towns and various other types of towns. Sometimes many towns combined for several functions. They were administrative towns, temple towns, as well as centers of commercial activities and crafts production. Throughout the history, they served as center of culture and civilization. Capital cities. Capital cities in the past were primarily the chief towns where the administrative machinery was based. With the use of iron, the process of urbanization started taking root. It led to the rise of new towns during the time of Rajputs like Delhi, Kannauj, Ajmer, and during the time of Mughals like Agra and Fatehpur Sikri. Pilgrimage centers. Pilgrimage centers talks about temple town. In the medieval period, many pilgrimage centers emerged. People believed that visiting this pilgrimage center will wash away all their sins. There were different pilgrimage centers for the Hindus and Muslims. The temple authorities received land grants in which they used to collect taxes. They also received huge donations from devotees. Thus, temples like Somnath became storehouses for wealth. This wealth were used for maintaining temple and its elaborated rituals. Every day, people visit these temples in large numbers during auspicious periods and festivals. Commercial centers, it is also known as trading towns. Indian merchants had been engaged in trade-related activities since ancient time, not only within India, but also with other countries. They exchanged goods like spices, tea, silk, textile, semi-precious stones and other goods that was in different demand in the other countries. The formation of trading societies or shrenis, trade practices took a formal shape. Trade with Southeast Asia, Europe, Africa, Arabia was in full swing. New trade routes developed on land, giving rise to trading settlements such as Surat, Masulipatnam, Pataliputra, Dhaka, etc. Port towns. The long coastline of India and its extensive trade with the outside world during the ancient and medieval times paved the way for the emergence and growth of port towns. Cambay, Sobara, Bharuch, Surat, Goa developed on the western coast, while the eastern coast carried on trade via the ports of Tambalapalli and Visakhapatnam. These ports facilitated India's trade with Africa, West Asia, Europe and Southeast Asia. Modern Tamluk in West Bengal is situated at the same site where the old town of Tambalapalli exists. Similarly, modern Patan in Gujarat developed from the ancient town of Anhilwad Patan. Now let's talk about founded town. During Sultanate period, a number of towns and urban centers were founded. Ahmedabad owed its origin to Sultan Ahmed Shah, Murshidabad to Murshid Quli Khan. The Tughlaq rulers built the new cities of Tughlaqabad, Faizabad and Jahanpana. The Mughal ruler Akbar built his new capital city at Fatehpur Sikri, about 40 kilometers away from Agra. Shah Jahan built the city of Shahjahanabad near Delhi, which comprises of Red Fort, Chandni Chowk and Jama Masjid. Legends even attributed the creation of same new cities to religious leaders. The origin of Faridabad is traced to Baba Farid, a Sufi saint of the 13th century. Hampi, a case study. The modern Hampi is located in Karnataka on the banks of the river Tungabhadra. Its name Hampi is derived from Pampa, the ancient name of the river Tungabhadra. It stands within the ruins of Vijayanagara, the former capital of Vijayanagara Empire, 1336 to 1526 CE in northern Karnataka. The empire was founded by Telugu prince Harihara and Bukka in 1336. The area was chosen to be the capital because of its strategic location, bounded by the Tungabhadra River on one side and the hills on the other three sides. Virupaksha Temple, which is also known as the Pampati Temple, it was built earlier than the Vijayanagara Empire. The Hazara Rama Temple dates back to the early 15th century. The House of Victory was built by Krishnadev Rai when he came back from his victorious expedition against the King of Odisha. Vithala Temple is the most famous temple of Hampi. Its outer pillars are known as the musical pillars. Along with it, the Chariot Temple of Hampi is worldwide famous, as you can see over here. It is during the rule of King Krishnadev Rai of Vijayanagara the Hampi rose to prominence. It controlled the trade in the Indian Peninsula, except for a few commercial principalities along the Malabar coast. Hampi had trade connections with international markets. The Vijayanagara Empire came to a sudden end after the Battle of Talikota in 1565, when the city was ransacked by the Delhi Sultanates. Masulipatnam. It developed as a port city on the Coromandel coast in the delta of River Krishna. Masulipatnam was known for the production of cotton clothes known as chintz in Europe. Designs and color dyes were painted onto the cloth using a bamboo color or pen. This technique is called kalamkari. This kind of cloth had a market in Western Europe and Asia. Hence, foreign and local merchants competed for trade for this type of clothes. The city derives its name from a gateway in the town decorated with the eyes of a ship called Machli. It was a flourishing seaport during Satvahana rule. It is also one of the earliest non-British settlement in Indian subcontinent. It was British East India Company's first trading port on the Coromandel coast. In the 17th century, it was a center of French, British and Dutch trading companies. Surat. Surat is a port city situated on the left bank of Tapi River in the state of Gujarat. It became Indian main port under the Mughal and is where the British gained their first important center of the textile trade. Apart from British, French, Portuguese and Dutch also established factories at Surat. It became famous as a major trade center of India during the rule of Mughal Emperor. Surat is now the heart of Indian driving diamond polishing industries. Surat has also emerged as an industrial hub for the production of synthetic fibers and man-made fabrics. It surpassed Cambay as the major port on the western coast. The Portuguese were its master during the closing years of the 16th century. Later, the British East India Company made it their trade transmit point. In 1612, the British destroyed Portuguese naval supremacy and obtained an imperial firman. Firman means royal order, establishing a British factory at Surat. The prosperity of Surat suffered further when Bombay was made the capital of the British East India Company's possessions and trade. Surat was taken over by the British in 1759. Likewise, we have finished with this chapter. Thank you.